Good morning, one and all. Welcome back to the e-learning platform of the GS College of Commerce, Wardha. So today I'm going to discuss the subject Indian Economy. Under the subject, we will see our topic privatization. But in that particular topic, what we are going to say, we will see the privatization meaning. Similarly, the objectives of the privatization, as well as the conditions necessary for the success of the privatization, and the government measures which are adopted for the privatization process. Simultaneously, we are going to see here the arguments in favor of the privatization and argument against the privatization and the suggestions for the improvement of the process of the privatization. So these are the aspects which we are going to discuss today. Let's see what is the privatization. So before that, we will see the process of the privatization. We all know that there is a private sector as well as the public sector. These are the two sectors which exist in the economy. There is a capitalism as well as the socialism, and one of the economic system is a mixed economic system which India adopted. And since the India adopted the mixed economic system, there both private sector as well as the public sector works together. So as far as the public sector is concerned, these are the undertakings which are run and managed by the government, which are in the form of the corporations, which are in the form of the government, companies, and the government departments, which we have seen in the earlier video of the public sector undertaking. Now, today we are going to see the privatization. So when we talk about the private sector, what is it? What does it mean? Private sector means the undertakings which are actually managed and run by the individuals. They are the owner, which are in the form of the public, which are in the form of the companies, joint stock companies. It may be also related with the sole trading concern. It may be related with the partnership firm, joint Hindu family business. Okay, so this type of the organizations we will see in the private sector or private sector. Now we will discuss what is privatization. So privatization is basically the process whereby the government is transferring its ownership to the public sector, private sector. Okay, it means that the public sector undertakings ownership is now transferred to the private sector, and the say of the government in the undertaking is reduced considerably. Okay, now we will see the certain definitions which are given over here. And what the definition says about the private sector, privatization. So privatization is the process of that reduces the involvement of the state or the public sector in the nation's economic activities. So it's a definition which is given by Professor D.R. Pinsey, according to which what he says that privatization is basically a process whereby the role of the state, the role of the government is reduced, the government's involvement is reduced in the nation's economic activity or the economic activity of the country. It means the role of the government or the public sector both are reduced, and the maximum extent the things are in the private sector. Okay, these privatization takes place in India, especially after 1991's reforms, LPG model when India adopted. So after that, the privatization takes place in India at a great extent, or to which we can say it is speedily increased in India. Now see what the Dr. A. Peter says about the privatization. Privatization, according to him, privatization is the transfer of function or activity or the organization from the public to the private sector. Okay, so again here also the same thing is explained, but the wordings are different. What is there? The ownership is transferred from the public sector to the private sector. Okay, so when we are talking about the privatization, under the privatization, the government sells off its equity, okay, to the private individual. The share percentage of the government also declines in the undertaking. This is in the form of the strategic sales. This is in the form of the disinvestment. Okay, so why are that? Basically, the government actually sells off the sales of its stake, which is there with the public sector, is transferred to the private sector. There is also one definition over here given, and which suggests something. See, privatization occurs when a government-owned business, operations, or property becomes owned by a private, non-government party. Okay, so when the non-government party is having the ownership, okay, of the business operations or property, then that is also called the privatization. And note that privatization also describes the transition of a company from being publicly traded to becoming the privately held. Okay, so if a public limited company is actually reduced or ceased to be the public limited company and wants to be private limited, so that process is also called the privatization. So, but we are not going to deal with that privatization process here. We are going to deal here with the privatization as the process whereby the government actually transfers its ownership to the private sector. Okay, now we will see what are the objectives of privatization. So there are the certain ideological objectives, economic objectives, fiscal objectives, administrative, as well as the socio-political objectives. So these are the objectives behind the process of the privatization. When we are talking about the ideological objectives, so what is that? It is actually the need at the international level. See, when we are talking about the globalization, liberalization, at that time the privatization is also required to be adopted. So when a country is going to become the globally interfering with the other countries or adopting globalization, okay, so a liberalization, so ideologically there is actually the spread of basically the capitalism. Okay, so it is one of the objective, that is the spread of the capitalism at the international level. So this is basically an ideological objective. There are the economic objectives. See, we have seen the different demerits or the problems which are there with the public sector. There is a problem of the inefficiency, there is a problem of the more cost, there is a problem of the overcapitalization, there are maximum time, the problem of the labor. Such type of the problems are always there which are associated with the public sector. So when we are talking about the economic objectives, the economic objectives of privatization are there to overcome such deficiencies of the public sector. When an undertaking is in the private sector, basically the efficiency of the organization is improved. Similarly, the cost, there is a strict cost control in the private sector. Okay, so cost is there, cost control, if you are talking about the cost control, if you are talking about the efficiency of the workers, and similarly to achieve the rapid industrialization in the country. So these are basically the economic objectives. So considering these economic objectives, basically the privatization is adopted. The next thing is that the fiscal objectives. The fiscal objectives, the government normally suffers with the fiscal deficits. The government suffers with the problem of financing also. Government faces the problem of financing. So when the government is making the disinvestment of the PSUs. At the time, what is there? The government also gets the fund, which the government can utilize for the further development of the country. So they are the fiscal objectives. Under the fiscal objective, basically the main concern is that to reduce the fiscal deficit of the country. Okay, similarly, to earn more and more foreign currency, at the same time to increase the return on the invested capital. So these are basically the fiscal objectives. They are also the administrative objectives, that is to strengthen the industrial management. Okay, similarly, the socio-political objectives are related with the trade unions. Okay, to make them if you are talking about the trade union, basically what we find, there are certain irregularities which are found in the trade unions. Okay, so they are, we are considering this, the socio-political objectives, they are in more line with the need of the corporate world. Okay, so these are basically the socio-political objectives. Similarly, the ideological objectives, economic objectives, fiscal objectives, administrative objectives, and the socio-political objectives. Now, what are the conditions which are necessary for the success of the privatization? Basically, see, the political willingness. There should be the politically strong willingness of the political party at the central level, which are ready to privatize the different public sector undertakings. Okay, so the political entry, freedom of entry, less susceptible to fraud. See, we find many times, basically, the private sector suffers with the frauds, and sometimes we find there are different levels of misappropriation takes place over here. So if such things are to a greater extent less, then again, what we'll find there, we can promote the privatization in such country. Institutional arrangements requirement. Similarly, we can measure the outcome of the privatization, and there should be the equity. So these are basically the conditions which are necessary for the privatization. Now see, what are the measures which can be adopted for privatization? So the contraction of the public sector. Basically, see, these are the measures which are adopted for the privatization. Contraction of the public sector. Earlier there were 17 specific areas which come for the private sector only. Okay, where only the private sector undertaking can work. But now that has reduced from 17 to 3. So what is there? The contraction of the public sector. Similarly, the sale of the share of the public sectors. Okay, similarly, we can say increasing the share of the private sector investment, that is the private sector's shareholding is increased, that is they can have the more percentage of shares of the public sector undertaking. Disinvestment in the public sector industries, the government can sell off the public sector industries by way of the disinvestment. Okay, similarly, no insistence in the conversion. See, what we find, insistence on conversion. Basically, what we find, the financial institution normally insist the PSUs or which suffer with the industrial sickness to convert their loan into the equity. So that is also reduced. Sick industries are also treated like the public sector undertaking. Sick industries are also treated in the same line with the private sector. There is actually the memorandum of understanding. This memorandum of understanding is there for classifying the different public sector undertakings, whether they are profitable, non-profitable, and so on. So this is basically the measures which are taken for the privatization process. Okay, in the next video lecture, we were going to see the arguments in favor and against and the measures which are taken to privatizations or suggestions for the privatization.